接下来我们就来到了这个义的这个灌顶的部分。我们已经得到了义的灌顶，得到此灌顶之后，一切由义所累积的染污与执着习气皆得清净。一切义之灌顶受以受之，故可以观修本尊明空不二之心性，并获得成就法身之加持。在这世上有许多的不同的观顶，我们观想不同的形象，也有许多不同的这个咒语，那真几乎是说无可计量的数字。但是究竟而言呢，我们的在最后呢，就是回到了我们的义的灌顶，主要就是吽字代表的这个义灌顶的部分，一切都回归于这个吽种子之吽，主要就是究竟的究竟地的空性之境。究竟来讲呢，在在有许多无数不尽的这个咒语，但是本质上都是一样的。那轮回跟涅槃是不分的，最后都是消融到吽字，这就是一切圆满次第的形状态。不管我们是做哪一个那个本尊的修持呢，但是这些修持的圆满次第都回归到吽字，在大圆满的修持有介绍的阿种子之阿自生的这个代表空性，吽字呢明性代表明性的部分，但是它也代表的空性。曾经有人讲，当一个人知道真正知道如何修密咒称的时候，当我们讲吽字的时候，并不是只是说嘴巴发出的一个字或一个音而已，这个种子之吽字呢的音声呢，是从这个脐轮那个地方。所以当我们讲这个吽字的时候，应该在脐轮那边有一种觉受，它有具有摧毁一切妄念的这种威力，所剩下的就是这个本然的状态，这是佛性的状态。所以吽字是非常的具有大威力的，一切呢都是回归到吽字。那你们如果熟悉文殊阎摩嫡的修持法的话，那我们知道说吽字是非常重要，以及吽字的功德，甚至这个普巴金刚的修持也是一样的。前几天我们提到吽字呢是非常珍贵的，无论你是进行什么样的修法，吽字呢让你的心是变成一个无念的一个状态，因为这个在这个无念的状态的心性当中的了解他自己的本质，这就是心的本质状态，本性本质状态就是空性之外也有明性，这个是修持吽字非常珍贵的地方。昨天主本人不见，也有给我几本这个吉田松公的秘密的总集，在这边讲到说，当你修持法身上师的法身，主要就是修吽字。当你修吽字，当你修这个上师的这个报身的话，是修他的本尊。当你修化身的时候，一定要的意念上师， 最有前景虔诚心的上师等等，那来禅修这个上师，这个是吉田颂根祖师从他的秘籍秘密总集里面收出来的。我希望我所讲的根据这个所讲的是没有任何的错误的谬误的。弘字是代表这个心的本质，本来就是本质清净的，具有摧毁一切意念心概念心的妄念，它本质本性是这性空的。这就把我们这个就是我们究竟的三昧耶界。当我们在心中没有任何的执着没有执持的时候，这个就是可以说是圆满了究竟的三昧耶界。那主要就是代表心没有执着任何的念头，但 在这个时候念头还是会升起，我们还是会有自他的二元的这个对立执着，所以在这个相对的这个境界当中呢，我们要修利他。当我们升起悲心的时候呢，这个自他二元对立的念头自然就被得到消融，再回到弘字，再回通整回到弘字中当中。所以弘代表是空悲双运，也就是明空双融，这个就是本尊之心，也就是你自己的本心，这个就是根本的三昧耶。即使你的接受了100个灌顶，它这个根本的三昧耶呢，在相对地来讲，主要就是讲修持利他心跟那个慈爱心。在究竟来讲，在含藏在弘字里面呢，代表的了解了悟到自他无二的道理，不分的道理。这个就是根本的根本三昧耶界。这就是为什么我经常在这个卡片上印上弘字，在普巴金刚的法本上的修持有提到这一点。那在修法结束的时候，再升起本尊，那本尊的觉知的保持，有这样子的觉知的话，所吃的一切等于变成对准本尊的那个会供。所以在心的层次来讲，我们的三昧耶所要保持的就是这个弘字。每一个不同的观点有各自的三昧耶，那有一个共同的三昧耶界。在究竟来讲，主要就是我们要保持正念之心，不分心，在相对的层次来讲，要不要离开利他心。究竟来讲，空悲双运，没有任何一个本尊，没有这样子的一个三昧耶。无论你修什么样的本尊呢，即使是修任何一个法本，都是同样的三昧耶。那或许你在看某些法本有特别的规定的三昧耶，你要讲说我要把这个本尊视为我主要的本尊，只是证悟之前不会舍弃这个本尊。但是我们要知道每个本尊都有它的身与意，其中意的部分是最重要的，我们必须要了解本尊的这个意的层次是最重要的，不要去舍弃这个本尊。这个就是我们的三昧耶。那接受到这个三昧耶之后，我会来跟大家证明你得到的灌顶，你的接受灌顶之后，你就可以自行离去了。那这就是我们这个灌顶的三昧耶，希望大家能够了解。红红红红红红红红红红红红红红红红红红红红红红红红红红红红红红红红红红红红红红红红红红红红红红红红红红红红红红红红红红红红红红红红红红红红红红红红红红红红红红红红红红红红红红红红红红红红红红红红红红红红红红红红红红红红红红红红红红红红红红红红红红红红红红红红红红红红红红红红红红红红红红红红红红红红红红红红红红红红红红红红红红红红红红红红红红红红红红红红红红红红红红红红红红红红红红红红红红红红红红红红红红红红红红红红红红红红红红红红红红红红红红红红红红红红红红红红红红红红红红红红红红红红红红红红红红红红红红红红红红红红红红红红红红红红红红红红红红红红红红红红红红红红红红红红红红红红红红红红红红红红红红红红红红红红红红红红红红红红红红红红红红红红红红红红红红红红红红红红红红红红红红红红红红红红红红红红红红红红红红红红红红红红红红红红红红红红红红红红红红红红红红红红 除此之外，还有对关于Home还有一点非常重要的要跟大家说明，在我们跟道果的层面来讲的都是Home字。Home安住在根基之上，基地之上。在一切众生来讲，在这个相对层次而言，就是我们身里面所有的气，我们身体上有种种的这个气脉，常常在那边有一些脉动。这个我们这个我们的心的脉动啊，我们身体的脉动，事实上是控制在那边脉动的。我们要知道控制呢，就是我们维系的气在我们身体当中游动，造成我们身体的一种脉动的这种觉受。当你能够了解到的这一点，你去注意自己的身体的时候，你可以感觉到这个脉动在我身体里面移动游动。那事实上，在你身体周围充满了轰字，轰轰轰。当你在持咒的时候呢，一切的轰字，这个咒语都归回到这个轰字。当你在持受这个密咒的时候，也是这样子的。那当你在持咒的时候，这个轰字自然而然就在安在那里。这个就是轰字以及它的音声都在那里。当你能够了认它到底是什么东西在那里，你都知道身体呢一切都充满的轰字。你要知道你的心跟你的气呢都是轰字，它的本质是空性的，这就是所谓的根。这是一切众生心的本质。所谓轰的这个道呢，这是本尊的生命力。在这个道上你长养三种对本尊的信心，清楚的、渴望的、坚定的信心。你能够了解这个，透过你的修持，你了解到本尊的这个生命力，控制的这个果，修行的果呢？当你称这个控制出来的时候，这个它有具有的摧毁一切这个世俗念的威力。在那个时候你心性就是明空不二的，就是佛经的这个接下来讲到文殊的三昧经，在一瞬之间呢，你就是一个佛。这主要就是因为你心的本质就是纯净，如同虚空一般。只是因为我们自己的烦恼跟妄念呢，染污障碍的它的清明之状。当我们那个在一刹那间把它清除了这些云的话，你自然可以看到太阳。在这一瞬间，你就是佛。 一切精明，这就是哄字的这个果。在根本上，这是你的本质。你在修持的时候呢，你了知你原本就在那里的。接下来就是灌顶之后的要持守的三昧耶。请问在场在这边有多少是修持文殊耶摩耶，请举手。大概有三四十个人举手吧。如果你是修持文殊耶摩耶的人呢，你可以对这应该是很熟悉的。但我们在修这个文殊耶摩耶的的过程当中，许多我们要说要保护的众生，当我只要我们还是有自他二元对立的念头的话，那这些众生都以那个逆字来做代表。为了要保护他们，我们把逆转化成哄字。所以本质上来讲，一切的众生转化成哄，那就是我们如何来保护他们，他们如何自然的融入。因为哄代表的是自他无二的本质，他们进入到这个究竟地的一个境界，那因此他们被受到保护。对于你们熟悉文殊耶摩耶的修行的人，你对于这一点你们应该清楚，这就是修哄字的这个利益跟功德。许多上师在提到说保护藏目的时候，这个就究竟就是这一点，所以也是为什么它那么珍贵的原因。所以呢，预备三阶堂讲究圣法，汤戒达拉公叔叔大举腾戒中的解释三秋宁波拉西戒巴杜巴那波前波
去中松马松前
是那个中间松懈，等于什么？
你念前的，
你念前的，
这里是，
这里是，
大碗酒，
大碗酒，
等于，一些我一些把人那样，等于他着就吃的红吃那个吃的东西了，反正吃那个人家吃的要嘞，着不上我吃的，吃的最近啊这里，夹着不要嘞，对吗？他当中我包括上网说的说喊人压压嘞。也许我们五十小时的八卦路的松马的松，那么可以把这多少的忙的松了。说说看，亚人说看，何光是说何必是你，何必是你的？马格罗曼的空的那个皮啊，咔嗒的地方，那他马格罗曼很皮的。你这一路上这种说话，这里常常加一点，这里还是杂七八的。这个呢，五十小时的松马的。
这虽然说马哈嘎拉本身是一个智慧尊，他却以那个护法的那个支持的形象显现，身为那个修行者的这个友伴伴。 那它代表的是佛陀证悟的这个事业，来利益众生。在我们未来世当是我们非常好的友伴，并且为我们带来保护。在我们这个马哈嘎拉的这个修持，在我们这个供养这个食指这个供饮的修持当中，有提到马哈嘎拉的修法部分。在这个这样的修持，他直接显现的用这种形象显现，有的时候可能会用这样的形象显现。所以你如果有修马哈嘎拉的话，能够供饮，这个是很好的。等你受到了这个灌顶之后呢，当你上来接受这个灌顶的时候，我们会持诵那个普贤王如来祈愿文，那我们会持续的这样的念这个祈愿文，一直到所有的人都得到灌顶之后。大家列队上去慢慢的来接受灌顶。普贤如来祈愿文：后，万象轮涅诸一切，积一道二，结果二，觉与无明所变现。普贤如来之愿力，愿一切于法界功现证圆满，皆成佛。一切之机无为法，自生广欲无缘权，轮回涅盘恶名无。若觉此性即是佛，无明众生轮回破，唯愿三界有情众，觉了无权机之意，普贤如来于亦然，无有因缘机之意，此于机中自生觉，无有外内增损过，不染失意于暗障，是故自显不染垢。安住自觉本来处，三界不异不恐惧，于五妙欲不贪恋，自生无念心事中，无时声色无五毒，觉之光明无主智，一体性中五智慧，五种智慧成熟矣，生出五方本出佛，从彼智慧亦欲增。四十二尊佛陀生，无智慧之开显力，生出淫血六十尊，是故本觉不迷乱。因我乃是本初佛，以我所发之愿力，三界轮回之有情，是得自生明觉矣。唯愿大智无量缘，我之化身不间断，化现具足不失意，应机调伏眼诸相，以我悲心之愿力，三界轮回诸有情，愿从六道中解脱，起出有情诸迷乱，明觉不显于本机，失诸意念呆滞盲，此即无明迷乱因，昏聩当中刹那间，恐惧心事乱驰窜，由彼至他敌直生，习气见次凡之争，依序产生轮回法，烦恼五毒由此争，五毒之业不间断，是故有情迷乱机，乃是失意无明故，普贤佛我之愿力，一切明觉愿自知，具时生起之无明，是为失意涣散心，遍计所执之无明，乃是执着至他恶，具生遍计二无明，具有情之迷乱机，普贤佛我之愿力，轮回有情众生之失意昏昧黑暗除，二执心事皆清净，明觉本源愿得事，二执心者即犹疑。 生出维系贪爱惑，出后习气见赤征，食财依助与朋友，五庙欲与持亲戚，贪恋所爱之欲恼，彼等迷乱世间法，能取所取业无尽，贪之果报成熟时，投生贪吝恶鬼道，被收即可极悲惨。普贤佛我之愿力，贪吝欲爱诸有情，外欲可求不须舍，内贪爱欲不复取，心事松坦自处矣，明觉安守自壮矣，片观察自远得正，于外境界之显象，维系恐惧心慈善，嗔恨习气凡之争，直敌打杀出报生，嗔恨果报成熟时，地狱烧煮及痛苦。普贤佛我之愿力，六道有情众生之凶猛嗔恨生起时，不取不舍松之处，明觉安守自壮矣，清明智慧远得正，自心变成傲慢时，与他竞争轻灭心，强烈我慢心生起，自他饱尝纷争苦。此业果报成熟时，投生天道报尽堕，普贤佛我之愿力，生起傲心诸有情，当下心事松自处，明觉安守自壮矣，平等性义愿得正，二执凡争之习气，欲自毁他众伤业，度心争斗争长矣，投生砍杀修罗道，果报堕入地狱道，普贤佛我之愿力，生起度心争斗者，不作敌执松自处，明觉安守自壮矣，愿正事业无碍智，失意放任心涣散，盖障昏沉与遗忘，昏聩懒惰和愚痴，漂泊无依畜生果，普贤佛我之愿力，愚痴昏沉黑暗中，升起正念之光明，无分别智愿得正，三界一切诸有情，本居与佛我等同，流入失意迷乱机，今日造作无意业，六业犹如迷幻梦，我乃本初原始佛，为调伏故化六道，以普贤佛之誓愿，一切有情尽无余，唯愿成佛法界中。阿后今后俱立瑜伽室，无惑明觉至明中，发出如是大力愿，闻此一切诸有情，于三生内正成佛。值遇日始或月始，或是咆哮地震涌，冬至夏至转年纪，自身观为普贤佛，若普听闻此念诵，三界一切有情众，以此瑜伽誓愿力，痛苦依次消除矣，究竟佛果愿证成。
May you achieve the wisdom of equanimity. By increasing the habit of duality, by praising yourself and denigrating others, your competitive mind will lead you to jealousy and fighting, and you will be born in the jealous God realm where there is much killing and injury. From the result of that killing, you will fall into the hell realm. Through quintessential prayer,When jealousy and competitive thoughts arise, do not grasp them as enemies. Just relax and ease, and then consciousness can hold its own natural state. May you achieve the wisdom of unobstructed action. By being distracted, careless, and unmindful, you beings will become dull, foggy, and forgetful. By being unconscious and lazy, you will increase your ignorance.And the fruition of this ignorance will be to wander helplessly in the animal realm. Through Kuntusampo's prayer, may you beings who have fallen into the dark pit of ignorance shine the light of mindfulness and thereby achieve wisdom free from thought. All you Buddhas, beings of the three realms, are actually identical to Buddhas, the ground of all. But your misunderstanding of the ground causes you to go astray.So you act without aim. The six karmic actions are a delusion, like a dream. I am the primordial Buddha, here to train the six kinds of beings through all my manifestations. Through Kuntisampo's prayer, may all you beings, without exception, attain enlightenment in the state of Dharmasattu.
Yeah, everything is good.
Hereafter, whenever a very powerful yogin, with his or her awareness radiant and free from delusion, recites this very powerful prayer, then all who hear it will achieve enlightenment within three lifetimes. During a solar or lunar eclipse, during an earthquake or when the earth rumbles, at the solstices or the new year, you should visualize Kuntisampo, and if you pray loudly so all can hear, the beings of the three realms will gradually be liberated from suffering through the prayer of the yogin and will finally achieve enlightenment. Ho, everything, appearance and existence, samsara and nirvana has a single ground, yet two paths and two fruitions, and magically displays as awareness or unawareness. Through Kuntisampo's prayer, may all beings become Buddhas, completely perfected in the abode of Dharmadhatu. The ground of all is uncompounded, and the self arising great expanse beyond expression has neither the name samsara nor nirvana. Realizing just this, you are a Buddha. Not realizing this, you are a being wandering in samsara. I pray that all you beings of the three realms may realize the true meaning of the inexpressible ground. I, Kuntisampo, have realized the truth of this ground, free from cause and condition, which is just this self-arising awareness. It is unstained by outer expression and inner thought, affirmation or denial, and is not defiled by the darkness of unmindfulness. Thus, this self-manifesting display is free from defects. I, Kuntisampo, abide as intrinsic awareness. Even though the three realms were to be destroyed, there is no fear. There is no attachment to the five desirable qualities of sense objects. In self-arising consciousness free of thoughts, there is neither solid form nor the five poisons. In the unceasing clarity of awareness, singular in essence, there yet arises the display of the five wisdoms. From the ripening of these five wisdoms, the five original Buddha families emerged, and through the expanse of their wisdom, the 42 peaceful Buddhas appear. Through the arising power of the five wisdoms, the 60 wrathful Harukas manifest. Thus, the ground awareness is never mistaken or wrong. I, Kuntisampo, am the original Buddha of all, and through this prayer of mine, may all you beings who wander in the three realms of samsara realize the self-arising awareness, and may your great wisdom spontaneously increase. My emanations will continuously manifest in billions of unimaginable ways, appearing in forms to help you beings who can be trained. Through my compassionate prayer, may all you beings who wander in the three realms of samsara escape from the six life forms. From the beginning, you beings are deluded, because you do not recognize the awareness of the ground. Being thus unmindful of what occurs is delusion, the very state of unawareness, and the cause of going astray. From this delusive state comes a sudden fainting away, and then the subtle consciousness of wavering fear. From that wavering, there arises the separation of self and the perception of others as enemies. Gradually, the tendency of separation strengthens, and from this, the circle of samsara begins. Then, the emotions of the five poisons develop. The actions of these emotions are endless. You beings lack awareness because you are unmindful, and this is the basis of your going astray. Through my prayer, may all you beings recognize your intrinsic awareness. Innate unawareness means unmindfulness and distraction. Imputing unawareness means dualistic thoughts towards self and others. Both kinds of unawareness are the basis for the delusion of all beings. Guru Kuntasampo's prayer, may all you beings wandering in samsara clear away the dark fog of unmindfulness, clear away clinging thoughts of duality. May you recognize your own intrinsic awareness. Dualistic thoughts create doubt. From subtle attachment to this dualistic turn of mind, dualistic tendencies become stronger and thicker. Food, wealth, clothes, home, and friends, the five objects of the senses, and your beloved family, all these things cause torment by creating longing and desire. These are all worldly delusions. The activity of the grasping and clinging are endless. When the fruition of attachment ripens, you are born as a hungry ghost, tormented by coveting and desiring, miserable, starving, and thirsty. Through Kuntasampo's prayer, may all you desirous and lustful beings who have attachments neither reject longing desires nor accept attachment to desires. Let your consciousness relax in its own natural state, and then your awareness will be able to hold its own. May you achieve the wisdom of perfect discernment. When external objects appear, the subtle consciousness of fear will arise. From this fear, the habit of anger becomes stronger and stronger. Finally, hostility comes, causing violence and murder. When fruition of this anger ripens, you will suffer in hell by boiling and burning. Through Kuntasampo's prayer, you beings of the six realms, when strong anger arises for you, neither reject nor accept it. Instead, relax in the natural state and achieve the wisdom of clarity. When your mind becomes full of pride, there will arise thoughts of competition and humiliation. As this pride becomes stronger and stronger, you will experience the suffering of quarrels and abuse. When the fruition of this karma ripens, you will be born in the god realms and experience the suffering of change and the falling to lower rebirths. Through Kuntasampo's prayer, may you beings who develop pride, let your consciousness relax in the natural state. Then your awareness will be able to hold its own. May you achieve the wisdom of equanimity. By increasing the habit of duality, by praising yourself and denigrating others, your competitive mind will lead you to jealousy and fighting, and you will be born in a jealous god realm, where there is much killing and injury. From the result of that killing, you will fall into the hell realm. Through Kuntasampo's prayer, when jealousy and competitive thoughts arise, do not grasp them as enemies. Just relax in ease. Then consciousness can hold its own natural state. May you achieve the wisdom of unobstructed action. By being distracted, careless, and unmindful, you beings will become dull, foggy, and forgetful. By being unconscious and lazy, you will increase your ignorance, and the fruition of this ignorance will be to wander helplessly in the animal realm. Through Kuntasampo's prayer, may you beings who have fallen into the dark pit of ignorance shine the light of mindfulness and thereby achieve wisdom free from thought. All you beings of the three realms are actually identical to Buddha, the ground of all, but your misunderstanding of the ground causes you to go astray, so you act without aim. The six karmic actions are a delusion, like a dream. I am the primordial Buddha, here to train the six kinds of beings through all of my manifestations. Through Kuntasampo's prayer, may all you beings, without exception, attain enlightenment in the state of Dhammadhatu. Aho. Hereafter, whenever a very powerful yogin, with his or her awareness radiant and free from delusion, recites this very powerful prayer, then all who hear it will achieve enlightenment within three lifetimes. During a solar or lunar eclipse, during the earthquake or when the earth rumbles, the solstices or the new year, you should visualize Kuntasampo. And if you pray loudly so all can hear, and the beings of the three realms will gradually be liberated from suffering through the prayer of the yogin and will finally achieve enlightenment. Home, everything, appearance and existence, samsara and nirvana, has a single ground and yet two paths and two fruitions, and magically displays as awareness or unawareness. Through Kundasampo's prayer, may all beings become Buddhas, completely perfected in the abode of Dharmadhar II. The ground of all is uncompounded, and the self-arising great expanse beyond expression has neither the name samsara nor nirvana. Realizing just this, you are a Buddha. Not realizing this, you are a being wandering in samsara. I pray that all you beings of the three realms may realize the true meanings of the inexpressible ground. I, Kundasampo, have realized the truth of this ground, free from cause and condition, which is just the self-arising awareness. It is unstained by outer expression and inner thought, affirmation or denial, and is not defiled by the darkness of unmindfulness. Thus, this self-manifesting display is free from defects. I, Kundasampo, abide as intrinsic awareness. Even though the three realms were to be destroyed, there is no fear. There is no attachment to the five desirable qualities of sense objects. In self-arising consciousness free of thoughts, there is neither solid form nor the five poisons. In the unceasing clarity of awareness, singular in essence, there yet arises the display of the five wisdoms. From the ripening of these five wisdoms, the five original Buddha families emerge, and through the expanse of their wisdom, the 42 peaceful Buddhas appear. Through the arising power of the five wisdoms, the 60 wrathful Harukas manifest. Thus, the ground awareness is never mistaken or wrong. I, Kundasampo, am the original Buddha of all. And through this prayer of mine, may all you beings who wander in the three realms of samsara realize the self-arising awareness, and may your great wisdom spontaneously increase. My emanations will continuously manifest in billions of unimaginable ways, appearing in forms to help you beings who can be trained. Through my compassionate prayer, may all you beings who wander in the three realms of samsara escape from the six life forms. From the beginning, you beings are deluded because you do not recognize the awareness of the ground. Being thus unmindful of what occurs is delusion, the very state of unawareness and the cause of going astray. From this delusive state comes the sudden fainting away, and then the subtle consciousness of wavering fear. From that wavering, there arises the separation of self and the perception of others as enemies. Gradually, the tendency of separation strengthens, and from this, the circle of samsara begins. Then the emotions of the five poisons develop. The actions of these emotions are endless. You beings lack awareness because you are unmindful, and this is the basis of your going astray. Through my prayer, may all you beings recognize your intrinsic awareness. Innate unawareness means unmindfulness and distraction. Impeding unawareness means dualistic thoughts towards self and others. Both kinds of unawareness are the basis for the delusion of all beings. Through Kundasampo's prayer, may all your beings wandering in samsara
clear away the dark fog of unmindfulness, clear away the clinging thoughts of duality. May you recognize your own intrinsic awareness. Dualistic thoughts created doubt. From subtle attachment to this dualistic turn of mind, dualistic tendencies become stronger and thicker. Food, wealth, clothes, home, and friends, the five objects of the senses, and your beloved family, all these things cause torment by creating longing and desire. These are all worldly delusions. The activities of grasping and clinging are endless. When the fruition of judgment ripens, you are born as a hungry ghost, tormented by coveting and desiring, miserable, starving, and thirsty. Through Kundasampo's prayer, May all your desires and possible things have attachments, neither reject longing desires, nor accept attachment to desires. Let your consciousness relax in its own natural state. Then your awareness will be able to hold its own. May you achieve the wisdom of perfect discernment. When external objects appear, the subtle consciousness of fear will arise. From this fear, the habit of anger becomes stronger and stronger. Finally, hostility comes, causing violence and the murder. When the fruition of this anger ripens, you will suffer in hell by boiling and burning. Through Kuntusampo's prayer, you beings of the six realms, when strong anger arises for you, neither reject nor accept it. Instead, relax the natural state and achieve the wisdom of clarity. When your mind becomes full of pride, there will arise hope for competition and humiliation. As the pride becomes stronger and stronger, you will experience the suffering of curls and abuse. When the fruition of this karma ripens, you will be born in the God realms and experience the suffering of change and falling to lower rebirths. Through Kuntusampo's prayer, may you beings who develop pride, let your consciousness relax in the natural state. Then your awareness will be able to hold its own. May you achieve the wisdom of equanimity. By increasing the habit of duality, by praising yourself and denigrating others, your competitive mind will lead you to jealousy and fighting, and you will be born in the jealous God realm, where there is much killing and injury. From the result of that killing, you will fall into the hell realm. Through Kuntusampo's prayers, when jealousy and competitive thoughts arise, do not grasp them as an enemy, just as in peace. Then consciousness can hold its own natural state. May you achieve the wisdom of assorted connections. By being distracted, careless, and unmindful, your beings will become dull, foggy, and forgetful. By being unconscious, you will be crazy ignorance, and being ignorance will be to wander helplessly in the animal realm. Through Kuntusampo's prayer, may you beings who have fallen into the dark pit of ignorance shine the light of mindfulness and thereby achieve wisdom free from thought. All you beings of the three realms are actually identical to Buddhas, the ground of all. But your misunderstanding on the ground causes you to go astray, so you act without aim. The six karmic actions are a delusion like a dream. I am the primordial Buddha here to train the six kinds of beings through all my manifestations. Through Kuntusampo's prayer, may all you beings without exception attain enlightenment in the state of Dhammadhatu. Ah, ho! Thereafter, whenever a very powerful yogin with his or her awareness radiates free from delusion, recites this very powerful prayer, when all the hearers will achieve enlightenment within three lifetimes. During a solar and lunar eclipse, during an earthquake, or when the earth rumbles, at the solstice or the new year, you should visualize Kuntusampo. And if you pray loud so all can hear, the beings of the three realms will be gradually liberated from suffering through the prayer of the yogin and will finally achieve enlightenment. The Mozi 接下来这样说，十八页的那个祈愿文，吉田松公祖师的回向文。
Great
Vajradhara, Great Vajradhara, Baba, 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 May the auspiciousness of all Kagyu Lama prevail. Glory is holy, venerable, precious, kind Ruger in its groups. Divine Assembly and Edams, Assembly of Bhaktas and Bodhisattvas. Your ultimate beginnings and heirs of the abilities. All of you dwelling in the ten directions, please heed me. By the power of this vast root of virtue, may I benefit all beings through my body, speech, and mind. May the afflictions of attachment, hatred, ignorance, pride, and jealousy not arise in my mind. May all the compassion, respect, honor, and concerns for this life not arise for even a moment. May my mind stream be moistened by abundant kindness, compassion, and bodhicitta. And may I become a spiritual master with good qualities equal to the infinity of space. May I gain the supreme attainment of Mahabodhi in this very life. At the moment of death, may I not experience the suffering of being abruptly severed from this life. May I suffer a terrible death. May I not die confused by wrong views. May I not experience an untimely death. May I die joyfully and happily in the great luminosity of the mind itself and in the crystal clarity of Mahamudra. May I, in any case, gain the supreme attainment of Mahamudra at the time of death or in the bardo.
For this realm encircled by snow-covered mountains, you are the source of all benefit and happiness. Tenzin Gyalso Chakorten Rizig.
于此学令所绕国土中一切利益安乐之牲畜天津家措观自在菩萨愿尊常住直至轮回止掌持善扬三宝总集之释迦师子教法主宰者以普贤行利众盛世业任成其愿尊师莲主故尊者执持三宝之本怀 只供圣教发心力无伦开显正法良印圣安慰赤诸有情愿尊莲主故圣境之处阿雅提婆明多康地区硬化嘎种性世间护主心子确定巴具德嘎谦长寿住百劫
Crown of the Shakyas, kind friend to strangers, 17 great panditas, Talopa, Naropa, Marpa, Milarepa, Gampopa, Jiktansungun, and their lineage heirs, please bestow good fortune and auspiciousness. Protector Amitayas, transcendent Lord, who grants supreme life, everlasting, stable, and unchanging, who diverts from untimely death, anyone who merely hears your name or thinks of you, please bestow good fortune and auspiciousness. Living austerely in the higher training of discipline, full of compassion that is the glory of those to be tamed, devoid of all grasping, never parting from Mahamudra's natural state, Nyidam Tenpe Nima, son of the teachings, may your life remain firm. May the teachings of the great Drigompa, Ratna Sri, master of interdependence, omniscient lord of Dharma, who has seen all knowable things, be upheld until the end of cyclic existence through study, practice, hearing, contemplation, and meditation. Your thousand arms are the thousand wheel-turning kings.
Your thousand eyes are the thousand Buddhas of the Sangha. 诸位各家各诸位法友们，其实吉祥如意，也透过这个网络直播观看这个灌顶的法友们，也祝你们长寿。